much for being here tonight. I'm really excited to be presenting and curating tonight's Roots concert, celebrating Black History Month. Now, I've been looking forward to this for a really, really long time. We have an incredible program this evening. We've got a mix of classical, contemporary. We've got a premiere of Reuben Bance's piece, Prophylaxis, as jazz, everything. So I really, really hope you enjoy. It's just an hour of really incredible music and some poetry. And we're kicking it off with Mother and Child by William Barnsdale. Hope you enjoy. mother moved with him so that he could pursue a career in music, learn from the best, study composition, piano. He also taught himself guitar, wind instruments, and I think double bass as well. So William Glasgow was really, as much as possible, surrounding himself with music following the death and passing of his father. And his mother really got him through a very, very dark time, so he wrote that piece in honour of her. And now I'm really excited to introduce and allow Reuben to talk about his piece coming up next, which he wrote very recently. And he's going to come up and tell you a bit about his piece now.
So the title of my piece is called Prophylaxis. And prophylaxis is a word normally used in medicine. And it means kind of the prevention of disease. And I think it's really interesting how it applies to the civil justice movement that's going on right now. Because I think sometimes as a society we tend to act reactively rather than proactively. We kind of put a plaster on wounds rather than seeing why we're getting hurt in the first place. And so what I wanted to focus on is that kind of belief that there is a way where we can prevent stuff from happening rather than, I mean, we've seen with the movement during lockdown, the Black Lives Matter movement, how so often it takes something horrible to actually react while we should be really trying to create a society where that doesn't ever need to happen in the first place. And that was my inspiration for this piece. Thanks.
Downstream till the current ends and dips his wing in the orange sun rays and dares to claim the sky. But a bird that stalks down his narrow cage can seldom see through his bars of rage. His wings are clipped and his feet are tied, so he opens his throat to sing. The caged bird sings with a fearful trill of things unknown but longed for still. And his tune is heard on the distant hill, for the caged bird sings of freedom. The free bird thinks of another breeze, and the trade wings soft through the sighing trees, and the fat worms waiting on a dawn-bright lawn, and he names the sky his own. But a caged bird stands on the grave of dreams, his shadow shouts on a nightmare scream, his wings are clipped and his feet are tied, so he opens his throat to sing. The caged bird sings with a fearful trill of things unknown but longed for still, and his tune is heard on the distant hill, for the caged bird sings of freedom. Next up, we have another piece by William Brantstill. This time it's a duo for saxophone and piano, titled Romance. On piano we have Lily Petrova, and on saxophone we have Lucia Breslin. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
concert is it gives more exposure to incredible contemporary composers such as Erlen Wallen and Eleanor Alberger. Next up, we have a piece by Eleanor Alberger performed by Dennis on piano and Lily Payne on clarinet. They're performing the duo from the suite for clarinet, piano, percussion and wind. It's titled Dancing with the Shadow, and they've been working really hard on this, so hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
after the cowboy died, he had his bones tied to the horse so that he may ride with the horse forever. So our Ragnar paint sort of depicts that story, and there's quite a jolly sort of active theme throughout, and the melody sort of passes between the instruments. And so performing this, we have Alex Franklin on oboe, Alex Roswell Ryan on horn, Lily Payne on clarinet, Andy Cookson on flute, and Ever Suxney on bassoon.
Thank you.
Next up, we have another Hana Alberger piece, this time for solo cello, performed by Yena. I hope you enjoy. Commemorate the work of Erlen, so hope you enjoy.
Billie Holiday's burn voice had as many shadows as lights. A mournful candelabra against a sleek piano. The gardenia, her signature under that ruined face. Now you're cooking, drummer to bass. Magic spoon, magic needle. Take all day if you have to, with your mirror and your bracelet of song. Fact is, the invention of women under siege has been to sharpen love in the service of myth. If you can't be free, be a mystery.
As exciting as it has been to curate and organise this concert, I also have the pleasure of performing for you all. So the first piece I'm playing now is Deep River, which was originally an African-American Negro spiritual, and the words are actually, Deep River, my home is over Jordan, and it was sang during the slave era to kind of keep spirits up, keep hope alive, and that, you know, there'll be an end to this and an end to such a difficult time and a time of suffering. The transcription is by Samuel Coleridge Taylor, who was a black British of Creole descent composer of the 20th century. And it's taken from 24 Negro melodies, and of this, which is number 10, he said himself this was the most beautiful melody. So I'm really looking forward to performing it for you, and I really hope you enjoy.
Thank you. That after you died, all the black poets in New York City took a deep breath and breathed you out. Dark corners of small clubs, the silence you left twitching. On the floors of the gigs you turned your back on, the balled up fists of notes flung, angry from a keyboard. You won't be able to hear us. Try to etch what rose off your eyes from your throat. Out you bleed, not a sweet, or sweaty, through our dark fingertips. We drum, rest. We drum, thank you. We drum, stay.
This is an arrangement of a spiritual, which is credited to Wallace Willis. I've arranged it for brass quintet, and I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
business. Walking past each other, catching each other's eyes or not, about to speak or speaking. All about us is noise. All about us is noise and bramble, thorn and din, each one of our ancestors on our tongues. Someone is stitching up a hem, darning a hole in a uniform, patching a tire, repairing the things in need of repair. Someone is trying to make music somewhere, with a pair of wooden spoons on an oil drum, with cello, boombox, harmonica, voice. A woman and her son wait for the bus. A farmer considers the changing sky. A teacher says, take out your pencils, begin. We encounter each other in words, words spiny or smooth, whispered or declaimed, words to consider, reconsider. We cross dirt roads and highways that mark the will of someone and then others, who said, I need to see what's on the other side. I know there's someone somewhere better down the road. We need to find a place where we are safe. We walk into that which we cannot yet see. Say it plain, that many have died for this day. Sing the names of the dead who brought us here, who laid the train tracks, raised the bridges, picked the cotton and the lettuce, built brick by brick the glittering edifices they would then keep clean and work inside of. Praise song for struggle, praise song for the day, praise song for every hand-lettered sign, the figuring it out at kitchen tables. Some live by, love thy neighbour as thyself. Others by, first do no harm, or take no more than you need. What if the mightiest word is love? Love beyond marital, filial, national. Love that casts a widening pool of light. Love with no need to preempt grievance. In today's sharp sparkle, this winter air, anything can be made, any sentence begun. On the brink, on the brim, on the cusp. Praise song for walking forward in that light.
So over lockdown, as well as discovering lots of new composers, which you've heard tonight, we also discovered the African-American composer Margaret Bonds. Now, she improvised a lot of her work for most of her life, so very few of the works were actually written down, but luckily enough, Oxford Publishing have done an entire suite, an entire book for all her works for the African diaspora, and I've been lucky enough to get a hold of a copy. And so the work I'm performing now is Troubled Water, and the main melody, which you'll hear at least 10 or 12 bars into the piece, is taken from the Negro spiritual Wade in the Water, which was another song sang during the slave era. And it really sort of was, again, to do with water, that idea of motion and fluidity, and really just, God's going to carry me through the water. That's kind of the memento that's pushed throughout this piece, so I really hope you enjoy.
Thank you. you so much for coming tonight. Huge congratulations to Zara for putting on the most fantastic concert tonight. It must be something like 6 months since you first suggested the idea, and I said, go for it. And since I've done pretty much nothing to help at all, I think old white men like me have to apologise for being part of a society which, inadvertently or not, has created a situation where somewhere like the Purcell School for Young Musicians very often plays music by dead white men. And tonight you've shown us just how much we're missing out. And in kind of by way of recompense, can I make two challenges to you? One is that you all go away and learn a piece of music that is by someone who is not dead, by someone who is not male, and by someone who is not white. And the second is that may this repertoire become part of our standard repertoire in all our concerts, so that this isn't, wonderful as this concert is, it's not a one-off of Black History Month, but something that we just do as a matter of course, not in its own right, but as part of our curriculum and as part of our life as the Purcell School for Young Musicians. I have to thank you for putting us in this position, and I think really congratulations for everybody.
It would not have been what it was without Chelsea Becker and Reuben, Bance stage managing. Jonathan and Gabriel and Eva, your lifesaver, lighting, sound, everything that the technology behind it, we owe it to you. So thank you so much. Lastly, staff-wise, Mr. Hoskins, Ms. Wickens, Mr. Bunce, and Mr. Bell, who's not here, this would not be what it was without them, so thank you so much. So I'm really grateful I had the opportunity and the platform, you know, despite COVID and everything that's gone on, to, you know, present to you some really wonderful works, hopefully some things you haven't heard before, some composers whose names you didn't recognise, and really just open up the repertoire opportunity, really, and hopefully a lot of you will take something away from this and be really inspired, because these composers did such incredible things in their lifetime and never really got the praise or kind of, you know, pat on the back for the things that they did, so maybe now that they're gone, we'll appreciate them a lot more. So I hope you really, really had a wonderful evening, and I hope you really enjoyed yourselves, and I'm sure you guys are struggling to breathe by now, so. We have a really exciting encore for you guys. Lester's going to tell you a bit more about it, but it's everyone. Oh, Harry's going to tell you a bit more about it. But lastly, the posters that you've seen around the school, kind of in your face bombarding you, Eric Way designed that all digitally himself. I'm going to let these guys take over, but again, thank you so much, Jazz Ensemble, for coming in, and, you know, I hope you guys had fun. This is the last piece in the concert, and I hope you guys had a great time. Thank you so much.
Hello, everyone. We're going to play Summertime, John Coltrane's rendition of this. It's a well-known tune in the jazz world. Most notably played by John Coltrane. He's a saxophone. He was an avid activist in support for the rights of the black community. He used his music to raise awareness. Summertime comes from the opera Porgy and Bess, written by George Gershwin. It was significant because it was the first opera to feature an all-black cast and brought about the increased employment of black performances in American theatre. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
I hope you all really enjoyed this. Again, thank you so much for coming. And just a final note, this concert was also in aid of raising money for the Chineke Foundation. Just in case some of you aren't familiar, Chineke was founded by Chichi Nwaneku, and it basically has two orchestras, a main orchestra and then a junior orchestra, and it gives orchestral performance opportunities to black and minority ethnic musicians of all ages, so children and then adults, obviously, on the professional scene. You know, Chineke Junior were incredible this year in Britain's Got Talent, and Chineke have also performed in proms, Royal Festival Hall, that kind of thing. And so I'm hoping this concert will sort of inspire people to kind of, yeah, let's really support the ethnic minorities and black musicians and give them the opportunity and the platform like I have done today, and really just help raise money and keep it going and inspire a lot more people to take up music as well, because I hope tonight's demonstrated how incredible music really is. And again, thank you all so much for coming. There's a GoFundMe link on the Personal School's Facebook and Instagram. And if you want to talk about any of this stuff afterwards, then just come and find me. And again, thank you all so much. I hope you all loved it, and yeah, I'll see you around.